Hello everyone and welcome to this first Remixvideo tutorial. Today we will see together how to use Remixvideo as a plugin inside Ableton Live. So the first thing you need to do is to install Remixvideo as a plugin. For that, open Remixvideo and open the application menu in the menu bar. Among other options, you will see Install as plugin. Click on it. Then, grant access. You will then see a message box popping up telling you that you have successfully installed Remixvideo as a plugin. It also tells you where the plugins are located in case you need to retrieve them. Now that you have successfully installed Remixvideo as a plugin, you can now use it inside any DAW. And for the purpose of this tutorial, we will use Ableton Live 9 trial version to show you how to use Remixvideo as a plugin. Before assigning Remixvideo to a MIDI track, we need to find the plugin inside Ableton Live's library. Please note that before using Remixvideo as a plugin, you must close the standalone app and vice versa. Otherwise, you'll get an error message asking you to close the other instance before opening it again. Once Live is open, you will have two MIDI tracks and two audio tracks by default. Click on Plugins in the browser sidebar to access all your third-party plugins. In your VST folder, pick Remixvideo and drag and drop it onto a MIDI track, the first one for example. If you have other plugins installed from different manufacturers, it'll be located in a MIXVIBES subfolder. Now that we have assigned Remixvideo to a MIDI track, we will see different ways to use it inside Ableton Live. And for the purpose of this tutorial, we will use an Ovation Launchpad. Before going any further, don't forget to always select your controller in Remixvideo's preferences. The first way to use it is to jam audio and video samples in the session view of Ableton Live. First, create clips by dragging audio files from the browser into open slots. You can now launch them from your controller's session view. Now, go back to your MIDI track and select User 2 on your controller to launch video clips from Remixvideo. Now, let's see how you can record and edit a video track. Check that you have armed the right track and start the recording. Now trigger samples with your controller. Each MIDI note you see here triggers or stops a pad inside Remixvideo. Tap once to launch a loop, tap a second time to stop it. Before stopping the recording, make sure that you have turned off all the pads. Now let's see how you can launch MIDI clips from the session view. So here are my three MIDI tracks that I created by double-clicking in empty slots and creating MIDI tracks. Now let's launch one of these from the controller's session view. So first, audio samples. Then open Remixvideo and launch. And here we are. Now you can trigger Remixvideo pads or full sequences of samples by creating MIDI clips in the session view. As simple as that. Of course, plugin integration offers infinite potential, and there are many other ways to use Remixvideo as a plugin. But here are the three main ones to get you started. Now it's up to you. Think of anything, the sky's the limit. Thanks for watching this first Remixvideo tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe and to leave us a comment to let us know what you think about Remixvideo DAW integration or if you have any question regarding that matter. I look forward to seeing you soon with a new tutorial about Remixvideo, the intuitive video sampler.